I apologize if you hear a fan in the background. I really need the fan on because it's really warm in my room, and I really don't want to open my window because of my goddamn neighbors. So, now that we got that out of the way, this is going to be a video response to JesusFreak77's video that he put out 2 days ago called Gay Marriage. Why we must keep discussing this. So, in the video, in the beginning, he just rants about how God doesn't want people sinning, and that sin is bad, and being gay is bad, and all the religious evangelical bullshit. He then says, not in so many words, but he does imply it, that we shouldn't accept people how they are. We should try and make them change who they are for some bullshit reason that's in a 2,000-year-old storybook that isn't even said by their fucking God. It's said in the Old Testament, not in the New Testament. And since they're Christians, you'd think they would want to follow Christ. And I actually got into a discussion with a family member because my initials are JC and I have long hair and a beard. And my mother chimed in that Jesus wasn't an atheist, but I'm pretty sure if Jesus came back and saw the evangelical dipshits like Jesus Freak, Pat Robertson, all these other assholes trying to be so Christ-like, he would bitch slap them in the fucking face and renounce his Christianity. But that's just a little bit of an aside. Getting back to the topic, he said that we basically should say that what you're doing is wrong, you're sinful, you're sin, you're this and you're that, which isn't very Christ-like. Christ went around gathering people and absolving them of their sins and really accepting them for who they were. He accepted prostitutes for who they were, he accepted a whole host of people. I mean, I haven't gotten that far in the Bible, but Jesus is always seen as an all-loving being, a person who loves everybody. Being a hateful piece of shit is not very loving, is it? And then he goes into a fucking rant about abortion, and he says that people thought we lost the abortion issue in the 1970s with Roe v. Wade. And he says that people think that we should just give up on that fight, which you should. Because people like you think that contraception is bad and abortions are bad. I don't get that disconnect. How can you think that contraception is bad and abortions are bad? If you use contraception, less likelihood of abortions. And that's me breaking a fucking mental foot off in your ass. But anyway. He goes on to say that people who are accepting don't know scripture. He then ridicules those same Christians who want people to go to church regardless of what they do. Even though Jesus was a very accepting guy, he wanted everybody to follow him. But people trying to get people into church, try to get them into the holy light of Christ, are wrong for ignoring people's sins and accepting them for who they are. That's what the fuck, Jesus Freak, honestly. What the fuck? As I said before, Jesus is an all-loving being so he would accept people for who they are. He wouldn't just cast gay people because they're gay, lesbian, transgendered, or anything like that. And I mean, that's my one big problem with what Jesus Freak said. Because he says, love the sinner, not the sin. Well, being gay is a part of the sinner. They are a part of who they are. So if you don't love the sin, you don't really love those people. And isn't pride a sin? Isn't being so prideful and so ballsy that you put the fucking cock and cocky bit of a sin, Jesus Freak, thinking that you know what God fucking said in his book or what he actually believes now? Isn't that a little bit cocky? Isn't that prideful? Isn't that wrathful also to say that you're going to burn in hell? Isn't that wrath trying to punish people for who they are? Maybe I'm misinterpreting wrath, but that seems a little bit wrathful. Trying to hurt an entire group of people for who they are. That seems very wrathful. And those are mortal sins, Jesus freak. Pride and wrath are mortal sins. So who's more of a chance of going to hell, Jesus freak? Me, who's an atheist? Or you, for being a prideful Christian? And one who ignores the teachings of Christ? Who's going to hell? And who's in the wrong? That's all I gotta say about this. If he makes another video, I'll make a video response to him. And, as you may or may not have noticed, I made a script. A lot of it was a little bit ad-libbed, but the core of it was scripted. So if you liked the video, thumb it up. If you didn't like it, thumb it down. If you thumbed it down, make a comment explaining why you didn't like it. Share it around if you think as I think. Or make a video response saying why I'm wrong. But this is Resonator's End. Peace, love, harmony. And fuck you, North Carolina. Because you're stupid dickheads. That's all I gotta say about that. As I said, peace, love, harmony, and I love everybody for who they are, not what I want them to be. And maybe that's prideful, but at least that's a good thing to be prideful of. Peace out.